So we just wrapped. Actually, we're still shooting out there. Black curtain. We are in a 100-year-old Masonic temple that was closed to the public for 80 years. Might have to fact check that. Long time.
And action.
The Masonic temple in Asheville was closed for decades to outsiders.
We talked our way into renting one room on one day, one room on the other day. And we ended up taking over the entire building for 3 days. It started with me going, I could probably pull off a simple little easy thing in Asheville.
He lives large, Ben. He goes nuts. And he went nuts on the filmmaking.
65 crew members. We were up to 115 people.
All volunteers, all people who could be somewhere else getting paid what they're worth.
We've got 2 days and 100 setups. It's normal. It's what we do. At least that's what we do on a Ben Lovett project. Heyo!
We're gonna get this. We gotta get this.
Well, I've got this much room to tilt up. From this side, you come from this side, and you...
Easily the most ambitious thing we've tried to do with this yet.
On three, one, two...
It's mega collaborative. It's big time teamwork for something like this.
Everybody! Whoa. Folks! Ben, it's in place. Shall we?
Please. So it's rolling. Fly, please.
Originally, I just had this loose concept of an aesthetic, and then Paul Chatel came on board, and we started talking about the Edwardian age and the age of the Titanic and the era of spiritual fascination.
We came up with a story that was based on kind of a 1915 kind of thing, and he took the concept and just ran with it.
You're going to see a ballerina, contortionist, and a man reading poetry. We'll say that they represent the arts.
Twilight bosom doth bedazzle all eyes.
If any of us know anything about what's going on in the world, especially what's represented by the people in power with lots of money, is the arts are not being appreciated. They're not being protected by the people who have the ability to protect them. You represent those people. We talked about this as being sort of the realm of the subconscious and these people representing memories and representing all manner of things. And you more or less have this individual who's being summoned from the dead to entertain his own past. And so on the surface, we see this relationship between decadence and vice, and then underneath, we're kind of exploring that struggle to forget things that we once had but no longer need. When he thinks about this time and this era, it is inexplicably attached to one relationship. I want to introduce Miss Mandy Lauderdale. The song itself is about a relationship with all sorts of different things, but we were looking for a way to focus it all on something. And we were fortunate to find Mandy, who manages to hold all of that in a glance.
We'll definitely catch you on your right side.
Okay.
Thank you.
Can we give thanks for coming?
And then we started talking about that era. Turn of the century, right to the 20s. That time period where the class divide was so great that there was this novelty fascination with the supernatural and the occult. It was like a thing that rich people got into. And they were so entitled and so wealthy and things that it was like, why should they not be able to contact the dead?
Each person in the seance not only has history with the seer, but they have unfinished business with the seer. That's why they want to bring him back.
Looking good, everybody. Keep it going. Keep it going.
Action.
Oh! I've been constantly surprised by the guy. I mean, he manages to keep the larger picture and the small details in his head at all times.
Pictures up, pictures up, pictures up, pictures up.
And it has been, without a doubt, 2 or 3 days of complete madness up in here.
That looks great.
That's pretty wild. That's a wrap on extras.
No.
Are we ready for this? Are we coming?
We're right here with you.
Fuck yeah.
Let's do it. Good.